Hi everyone, it's Lindy Young from Pink Whisper Designs. Today we're going to make a little graduation promotion card, but I want to jump right into the stamps. I want to describe what we have here. These stamps to my left are the freebie stamps, and you get one of these with each $30 purchase. And you can see it's a whole collection of little houses. There's a schoolhouse, a cafe, a hotel, a candy shop, a bakery, and a pet shop. So these are really fun. And what Art Impressions has decided to do with these stamps is coordinate some add-on collections for this. So those, again, would be with a $30 purchase. Those are free. You cannot purchase those separately. And the next three stamp sets I'm going to show you are add-ons for this Village series. And these can be purchased as a bundle, the three sets as a bundle, and there is a discounted price for that, but they can also be purchased separately. So the three sets in the bundle would include the Village vehicles on the right, the Village accessories on the left, and also the Village signage, and I'll talk about that a little bit more. So you can see you have all of these items that you can incorporate in. The mailbox, a little bench, there's a lamp post, there's even a little stone pathway there for the front door or leading up to the front of the houses. So you have those two, and then you also have this Village signage set, which I just love this. These little stamps will fit in the little plaques on each of the houses. And I'll be doing a card on that for next week's video, so keep an eye out for that. I'll show you the little Village houses, and I'll show you how we stamp those little plaques with these sentiments. And this last set is not part of this Village series, but it was released at the same time as these sets, so I just wanted to give you a quick look at this. And it's called the Potting Garden Shed Set. And this is really cute. You get the little shed and the little pots that you can fill with your watercolor stamps, your little flowers and vines, and some cute sentiments. Love the sentiments. And then that little container, which you can also fill with flowers as well. So let's go ahead and get started on our card today. I've taken all those little Village vehicles. We're going to be using that set today. I've got them in my Mini Misty stamp positioner. I'm using some VersaFine Onyx Black ink to do my stamping, and I've got some Strathmore Bristol Smooth cardstock. So let's go ahead and stamp these two times, just flipping that cardstock around so that I can stamp the second set of those same images. And then I've just got a rainbow of colors here. I will list those down below for you so you know, but I'm basically doing the rainbow, and I'm going to start off with this red and color in the little bus. Now these are really easy to color in. I didn't spend a lot of time blending, really just using the one color on the bus, and I'll just blend that in. I'm using my blender pen to do my blending, but you can use a water brush here as well, so whatever you prefer. So again, these are quick and easy to color in. There are no coordinating dies for these sets, so later on, once I have all of these colored, I'm going to go ahead and use my detail scissors and cut these out, but I will leave a little white border around the edges just to make them easier to cut out. So I'm just kind of mixing up the colors here. So let's go ahead and color this little, the top of the truck here. I did use a little bit of that orange, and then I brought those two colors together just to get more of kind of like a creamsicle color. Now we've got the blue, and these little vehicles I think can be used for several things. That's why I wanted to show you, you don't have to use them just with the villages. You can use them in a variety of ways, and I thought this would make a great little graduation or promotion card. It's going to say, "You're really going places," and then on the inside it'll say, "Lookout World." So it's really fun. So I always like to look at my sets in different ways that I can use them. just because I get a lot more use out of them if I think of them in that way. I've got a little bit of light gray. I'll add that to some of the detail work on these vehicles. Let's just finish up this truck with a little bit of that green, and I will come in with a little bit of a darker green. And shortly, I'll be releasing another video where I'm going to use the little village houses. And we're going to create a summer beach scene, like a little summer village. It reminds me so much of going up to Maine in the summertime, just going through the little shops, and they're right along the shore. So that was what inspired that card. And again, that'll be out hopefully next week. And you might want to just hit that subscribe button so that when it comes out, you'll be the first to see it and you won't miss it. And then I grabbed my detailed scissors, as you can see, and I cut those out and left a little white border around the edges. I've got my gel pen, and I'm just adding a little highlight to some of these vehicles. Let me show you one of those up close real quickly. And then what I'm also going to do is grab my black Faber-Castell Pitt Artist pen. This is the 0.1 millimeter pen. This is a permanent black pen, and I'm just going to add a few little stripes to my vehicles. What's fun about these vehicles, I like that they're fairly plain so that you can add anything you want to these. You could even stamp some of that signage on the back of these trucks, so you have a lot of options. So once that's done, let's go ahead and just set these aside for now. And I've got a piece of Strathmore Bristol Smooth cardstock that I'm going to cut down to 5 1/4 by 5 1/4. We're going to create a square card today. And I want to add a circle in the center of this. So I'm going to use the Journal Template Circle Dies. And I'm going to just center that on this panel. I've got some post-it tape, which is just a temporary tape that will hold this in place while we run this through the die cutting machine. I'm running it through my Spellbinders Platinum 6 die cutting machine, and I've just centered that. And now I've placed it on my Wendy Vecchi Make Art Station. I am going to just add a little tiny bit of that Tombow tape to the back of this that will hold it in place. It will easily remove when we're done. I've got the Lawn Fawn Sunrays stencil, and you could just do the sunrays going in one direction or the other, but what I want to do today is have it look like it goes all the way around this circle. So I'm going to center it on this panel, just going halfway up. I'm going to center that, and then I'm going to add my magnets just to make sure that stays in place. And let's go ahead and do some ink blending. I've got the Squeezed Lemonade Distress Oxide Ink from Tim Holtz, and I'm going to go ahead and add that. So I'm using a medium-sized brush, and I'm just going to add that ink all over this background. And this Distress Oxide Ink blends so easily, so it's going to blend really beautifully. We're going to come in with a second color. I wanted it to be a little bit darker in the center of our sun rays, and I've got the Abandoned Coral. So we'll add that right at the very beginning of that circle, and then I'll go back to that Squeezed Lemonade brush, and we'll just blend that together nicely. You see there, I did add a little bit of post-it tape. I wanted to make sure I didn't go over the stencil at this point. We are going to be stenciling that, but I didn't want to brush on the wrong color. So I'm going to line that right up with that halfway point. So I'm just lining up the bottom of the stencil right along that color that we already placed down, and put my magnets in place again, and I'll do the same exact thing on this other side. Don't forget to put your post-it tape down or something there to mask that off. So I went ahead off camera and I finished up that stenciling on the other side. And look how pretty this is. I just love how this came out. So we've got those beautiful sun rays all the way around. Now, I wanted to create a little globe, so I've got the Stampers Anonymous stamp set that was done in conjunction with Tim Holtz, and this is called the Schoolhouse Blueprints. We're going to grab that little globe, but all of these images would be great for a graduation card or a teacher appreciation card. This is a great set. I love their sets. And we're going to go ahead and just ink up that globe portion of this stamp. We don't need the rest of it for now. So let's go ahead and stamp that. Again, I'm using the Strathmore Bristol Smooth cardstock. I am going to ink it a couple of times just to make sure I get a nice crisp stamping. And then let's go ahead and heat set that quickly. I did off camera heat set that quickly just to make sure it was dry before I came in with my markers. I've got blue and aquamarine blue, and we're going to do the water section of the globe. Now I'm starting off with that lighter color, then I'll add that darker color right up against the land, and then we'll kind of pull that in towards the middle. So I'm just creating a little bit of a shadow around all those land masses, and it will be lighter in the center. And in a little while, we'll add some Wink of Stella to the water, and it's really going to make this water pop. So I'm going to do that all the way around. And you'll see that gives a nice shadowing right up against the land. Now you could do this in some pretty turquoise colors. That would be really pretty, or add that to the water. But I thought I would stick to these blue colors that will coordinate with our little vehicles that we've already colored in. So let's just finish up the water and then we can go to the land. What I'm going to do is switch over to light green and dark green, and we're going to do the same exact thing. I'm going to add that light green first. We'll add a little bit of the dark green just here and there in some spots, just again to give it a little bit of interest, and then just blend those colors together. So this went really quickly as well. So next, let's go ahead and die cut this as a circle. So I just went through those same circle dies that we looked at before, that we used before, and I found the one that fits this globe perfectly. And what's great about that circle die set is there's so many sizes that they're just little increments larger than the next one, so it's perfect for finding just the right size. I'm going to take my Wink of Stella clear glitter pen. I mentioned that earlier, and I added that to the water, and look at that pretty sparkle that we get. So I set that aside to dry. Let's go ahead and create our card base. I've got the Hero Arts Arctic cardstock. This is a 100-pound cardstock, so it's going to be nice and heavy for our card base. We're creating a square card, so this measures 5.5 by 5.5. So the cardstock was 5.5 by 11 inches, and I scored it at 5.5 inches. Now do keep in mind it costs a little bit more to mail these square cards, so you do want to consider that when you're making this particular size. What I'm going to do now is stamp a sentiment on that inner part of the circle. So I'm just tacking down that frame and this little globe just temporarily while I figure out where that stamping is going to go. So let's take the Pack Your Bags stamp set and look at how cute these are. I've done cards with this set before, but we're going to grab that little stamp that says you're really going places. And I am going to cut it in half. So you want to carefully grab your detail scissors and cut this. We can always put it back together later on, but I want to have it look like it's kind of going around the top of this globe. So I'm just going to cut that, and then I'm going to lay that out so that it makes a little arch at the top of our globe. So what I'd like to do is just place that down approximately where it's going to go. We can now remove that frame. We don't need that. And what I'm going to do is just play around with this on my Misti, just kind of pushing those edges around just to create that arch. So it does take a second or two to play with that. And you can practice stamping that on a piece of scrap paper before you go to your cardstock if you prefer. And so here I'm just going to go ahead and stamp that. And now we can go ahead and attach that frame. I've got some Nuvo Deluxe Adhesive. I want to put plenty of glue around this so that it lays nice and flat on the card. You could also pop this up, but since we are popping up the little vehicles, I didn't want to add too much dimension, so I'll also glue the globe flat as well. And I'm just using my finger to make sure that glue is right up to the edges, and then we can position that in the center of the card. I'm just using a paper towel to press that down nicely, make sure it's nice and secure. And now let's go ahead and grab our little vehicles. And these are just so cute. And what I want to do is just position them around first, just kind of mixing up those rainbow colors, getting a nice collection. And then what we'll do is pop these up. This is where we'll add a bit of dimension to the card. I thought I might put that little motorcycle kind of going across the globe, maybe with a little arrow. That's something you could do, but then I changed my mind. I decided just to stick with these vehicles. In that little vehicle collection, there was also an airplane that had a little banner. That would be another cute way to add the banner across the globe with a little sentiment on that. So that's another option as well. I've placed some small foam squares on the back of the little vehicles. And I'm just using my Cricut weaving tool to pull the backings off, and then I'm going to pop all the rest of these up. So I did that all the way around. And I just lightly put them in place, and then once you're sure everything's where you want it to be, you can go ahead and press those down nice and firmly. I've got the graduation set from Art Impressions, and that's where I'm going to grab that little sentiment that says, "Look out, world." So this has some cute graduation sentiments and images as well. So I've got my card. I'm going to stamp this on the inside of my card, and since it's such a big card, I grab my Misty 12 inch. This is 12 inches by 12 inches so that I could place the entire card inside my Misty. You certainly don't have to do this. You could stamp that sentiment on a separate piece of paper and just glue it on the center of the inside of your card. So whatever you prefer, but I do love this large Misty for doing the insides of the cards, especially after you've finished one and you realize you want to add a sentiment. I've got those two leftover vehicles, and I'm going to pop those right inside. I just think this finishes off the inside and brings everything together. Now I've got the Pops of Color from scrapbook.com, and this is called Sunshine, and it's so pretty. It's this beautiful yellow. I'm going to add a few little dots of that here and there. And that little dot above the sentiment, I had a little smudge there, I will confess. So I thought I would add a little pop of color right there to cover that up. So now I've got that Wink of Stella clear glitter pen again, and I'm going to add it to the windows on all of my vehicles. Let's take a closer look at the finished card, and I just think this is so much fun. This is great for a promotion or a graduation. Even a retirement card could be fun. So I really hope you enjoyed today's video. If you did, please hit the like button and subscribe. And don't forget to hit that notification bell so that you don't miss a single video. Thanks so much for joining me today. I hope you all have a great day. Take care. Bye-bye.